Hello watch fans, today a comparison video I have really been looking forward making, and it's of course a comparison between two of the most famous anti-magnetic watches on the luxury market, the Omega Railmaster and the Rolex Milgauss. There is a third wheel, which is the IWC Ingenieur watch. If you want the complete trilogy or threesome of anti-magnetic luxury watches. So the 1950s was a great time in watches. Back in 1954, Rolex introduced the Milgauss. The Milgauss was a watch made for scientists, for people working at electromagnetic fields, because back in the days, magnetism really had a big effect on watches. It does as well today, but today more and more parts of the watch movements are becoming anti-magnetic. Back in those days, you had very simple movements and they would really get destroyed if they were in contact with strong magnetism. And doctors, scientists, people on the railways, electrical fields and stuff like that, they were in contact with very strong magnetic fields. Since then, Rolex has produced a number of the Milgauss versions. This version was discontinued in 2014. It had a run from 2007 to 2014. Today they produce the same watch but with a green tinted glass or the electric blue dial. Retail, this watch is approximately $7,500. The Omega Railmaster, or to give you the full name, the Omega Seamaster Railmaster, has had the same kind of bumpy history as the Rolex Milgauss. So this watch was originally introduced in 1957, the amazing year for Omega, because on the same day they introduced the Speedmaster, the Seamaster and the Railmaster. But the most uneven history, strange history, is definitely the one of the Railmaster. It has been introduced and then again taken out of production several times. They actually reintroduced four different Railmasters, a very faithful version in 38mm, then three more modern looking versions, this denim blue, a silver dialed and a black dialed. This has a retail price at around $5,000, but you could definitely get it for less. It's kind of hard to find pre-owned because it's a newer watch, but you can find it on the gray market, which I did, and pay approximately $3,900 for a full set. So this was produced this year, 2020, and the cool thing about this watch is that it has the master chronometer coaxial movement. So these two guys here are definitely the strongest anti-magnetic historical watches, because the IWC Ingenieur is kind of the weakest of these three original anti-magnetic watches, not because it's a bad watch, just because these two watches got more fame, although within the Omega lineup and the Rolex lineup, these are kind of the oddballs, the black sheep in the families. So why not start with the Omega Railmaster? So this is a 40mm watch in diameter. You get approximately 12.5mm in height. The lock-to-lock distance is really nice, of 46.5 approximately. And then you get a lock distance here of 20mm. The Milgauss states to be approximately 40mm, but it's a little closer to 41mm actually. It's a little bit taller at 13.1mm. Lock width of 20mm and lock to lock distance here of 48.6. Both of these watches are kind of on the heavier side. The heaviest of these watches is the Milgauss, but they're very much the same. The Omega is approximately 152 grams and this is approximately 156 grams. As you can see, both watches are no date watches. These watches are thicker than usual with no date watches, and that's because you get a metal plating inside of the watch to avoid magnetism. If you want more details on each of these watches, you can see the full reviews of both watches. They are down in the description, or you can click up in the right hand corner. It's the denim blue. This version comes on a denim blue NATO strap or on this very nice bracelet, Oyster style bracelet. I opted for the bracelet because I'm not really a big fan of the NATO strap. So this Particular reference number is a typical crazy Omega reference number. It's 220.10.40.20.03.001. It's powered by the coaxial master chronometer meta certified movement, the 8806. It has a 50-hour power reserve coaxial escapement. It was introduced in 2017, but this particular watch was produced this year, 2020. And the lume is Super Luminova, and we're going to have a closer look at the lume just in a few seconds. As you can see, it has a satin finish all over. Typical Liar style Omega case, which is almost the same case you see on the Speedmaster and on the Aquaterra. A very nice brushed all over satin finish also of the bracelet, which you can adjust by screws. Then you have a push button opening mechanism of this butterfly clasp. You have a sealed case back with the Seahorse anti-magnetic, 15,000 gauss of anti-magnetism, and as you can see down here, 150 meters of wall resistance. It has a cone-shaped screw-down crown. Everything looks printed, but actually the hour markings are kind of applied, but you see printed Omega logo, and then you get the numbers 12, 3, 6, and 9, Railmaster coaxial master chronometer Swiss made down here at 6 o'clock, this very nice texture dial, which changes color depending on the light, so you get a very nice dark blue color in lower lighting situations, and in strong light you get almost an electrical blue color. For the Railmaster you get a rust-colored second hand, and also down here in the middle above 6 o'clock and above coaxial master chronometer, Railmaster. Also a crosshair to tell you that this watch is very, very accurate. Simple baton style hands which are filled with lume. Moving on to the Milgauss, you can see this has a completely other style of finish compared to the Railmaster. This is high polish, and it's high polish of absolutely top class. Really nice high polish, but it is a smudge and scratch magnet. Screw down Rolex signed crown. 100 meters of water resistance, and if we look at the dial here, you can see applied Rolex logo and then printed Rolex Oyster Perpetual Milgauss. Superlative chronometer, officially certified and Swiss made down there at 6 o'clock. All the hour markings are also applied and filled with lume, which is the Rolex Chromalight. The biggest feature on this watch regarding the dial is definitely the second hand, which is this orange lightning hand, which is something that people either love or hate. I love it. You can see you get actually the same case as you get with the modern Air King. High polish, and then you get a bracelet with high polish in the center links, which is a smudge magnet again, tapering down, brushing on the sides, a really nice clasp with the EasyLink adjustment here, so you can provide yourself with a little more space for your wrist if it swells during the day. Solid end case back, typical very, very boring case back from Rolex. And again, this is a 100 meter water resistant watch. It is powered by the Rolex 3131 movement, which is a very anti-magnetic movement to 1000 gauss, but then it's 15 times less than the Omega. It has a 48 hour power reserve, and the particular reference number of this watch is the 116400. If we see both of these watches in profile, you can see just how different they are. So in design almost the same, but you can definitely see that the Rolex is a little thicker, and you can also see the difference in finishing because you get high polish compared to this more satin finish on the Railmaster. Also, you get screws to adjust the bracelet. The cool thing with the Rolex bracelet is that you get a very nice micro adjustment. You don't get micro adjustment on the Omega bracelet, but you do get half link, so you can easily find the right fit for you. But this on the go is much better if your wrists get just a little swollen during the summer days. As with this, you can't adjust it on the fly, unfortunately. And we're just looking at the watches side by side to see the dials. So the more conservative choice is of course the Rolex with the black dial. You can get it in white if you find a used example, and of course also the green tinted glass or the steel blue sunburst dial if you find the black dial a little too conservative and boring. So also having a look at the lume, you can see that the chromalite on the Rolex is green on the right, very strong, but I think that you get the best lume on the Seamaster, Railmaster, because you actually just get more lume applied and it's very, very strong and it has this really nice kind of icy blue color to it. So I think that the lume is definitely best on the Omega Railmaster, Seamaster, Railmaster. So as I said before, you also get a little better water resistance with 150 meters on the Railmaster compared to the Milgauss with 100 meters, but both have screw down crowns and very acceptable water resistance tolerances in my opinion. Both bracelets are really, really nice. I will give a little plus to the Milgauss because it's just a little softer and a little more soft in the finishing, and you get the micro adjustments which you don't get with the Railmaster bracelet. Although this is a high quality bracelet, it still loses out to the Rolex bracelet, which is really, really good. So if we look at the accuracy, you actually get the most accurate watch with the Omega, which is Meta certified, which is a harder test than the usual COSC test that the Milgauss goes through. So you actually get better testing and actually get a little more accuracy with the Railmaster. It's tested to 1.7 seconds plus a day, which is also the measurement I get. This has a tolerance of plus 2 seconds a day, the Milgauss, which is also the measurement I get. So at the end of the day, it all comes down to both price and taste. So do you want something that is definitely a great investment, which will keep the price and maybe also go up in price? Then you go after the Milgauss. This is the more shiny, dressy, flashy watch of these two. If you want a really cool original choice, which is definitely also a very playful watch, and you want to get into high-end luxury watches, but don't want to actually destroy your bank account, then I can definitely recommend the Railmaster. Both of these watches are keepers in my collection for sure. This has a lot of pluses. This feels a little more modern overall than the Rolex Milgauss, although this is of course a modern Rolex, which is a high quality watch. I can't decide which of these watches is my favorite right now, as I got this most recently, the Railmaster. I'm wearing this almost all the time. But the Rolex Milgauss, it stays a little longer in the bank box. But I definitely also enjoy this watch, and it's a really cool, different Rolex watch. Everyone wants a GMT Master or a Datejust or a Submariner. But if you get the Milgauss, you get the very original and also kind of unpopular choice, which I really like. And it's actually kind of the same story with the Omega. Everyone wants a Speedmaster or a Seamaster, but the Railmaster is really the original choice. So two strong 1950s introduced anti-magnetic watches. This 15 times more anti-magnetic and more accurate and with a little bit of power reserve and better water resistance than the Rolex Milgauss. I hope you enjoyed this comparison. And if you did, don't forget to give me a thumbs up. It's really a big help to make this video get more views and more attention. Don't forget to leave a comment down below which of these is your favorite, or other versions of these two watches is your personal favorite. Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram and Facebook and subscribe to my channel and visit my website wristwatchpassion.net. Thank you. Bye.